Now, let us study the next topic, microspore and pollen grains. Now, what are these pollen grains? Pollen grains are haploid, uninucleate, minute spores produced in large number as a result of meiosis in microspore mother cells inside the microsporangia. So, these are the pollen grains. They are also male gametophytes. Pollen grains are male gametophytes. Now, these are the stages of a microspore maturing into a pollen grain. Let us discuss these stages one by one. See, microspore is the first cell of gametophytic generation. This is a microspore. Stages of a microspore, how can it develop into a pollen grain? So, microspore is the first cell of gametophytic generation. It starts germinating in C2, means when it is enclosed inside the microsporangium or pollen sac. So, it starts germinating inside the pollen sac. Freshly formed microspore. This is the freshly formed microspore. It has rich cytoplasm with centrally placed gametophyte and a prominent nucleus. Basically, it has rich cytoplasm with prominent nucleus. See, this is the nucleus. This is the prominent nucleus inside it. So, prior to first mitotic division, the nucleus of the microspore become displaced to peripheral position. See, the nucleus starts displacing to peripheral position and here large vacuole starts appearing. Simultaneously, the wall of microspore continues to differentiate. Microspore nucleus then divides mitotically. Division of nucleus starts taking place, mitotic division, and it divides into two daughter nuclei. Now there's a wall. Oblique wall is laid down between these two nuclei and two different cells are produced. See, an oblique wall is laid down between them and two unequal cells are there. The larger cell is known as vegetative cell, while the smaller cell is known as generative cell. So, these are the two cells which appears after the division of this nucleus. This nucleus get divides and now you can see this two unequal cells are there. Now, a layer of callose, C-A-L-L-O-S-E, callose is developed in, around this generative cell. The generative cell, then it loses its contact with the wall of microspore. This is the wall of microspore. Generative cell loses its contact with the wall of microspore and comes to life free in the cytoplasm. This cell finally, it lies freely in the cytoplasm like this. This cell comes this side. It lies freely in the cytoplasm. And after that, this generative cell has limited number of organelles and the vegetative cell has a lobed central nucleus. This is the vegetative cell. It has lobed central nucleus lie in the vacuolated cytoplasm. See, vacuoles are still there in this cytoplasm, packed with organelles, starch grains, lipids and proteins. So, in majority of angiosperms, the pollen grains are shed from the anther at this bicell stage. This is the bicell stage when generative cell and vegetative cells are present. But in some genera, both the monocotyledons and dicotyledons, the generative cell divides prior to the dehiscence of the anther. This is the generative cell and it divides prior to the dehiscence of the anther and pollen grains shed at three cell stage. In few plants, pollen grains shed at three cell stage when this generative cell divides. Approximately 70% of species shed their pollen cell at two cell stage. This is two cell stage and 70% of species shed their pollens in this stage when there are two cells and rest 30% in three cell stage. So this is the development of a pollen grain. What are the stages of a microspore maturing into a pollen grain? Now come to the structure of a pollen grain.